गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू टाटा केम डीएवी पब्लिक स्कूल मीठापुर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस।
मायसेल्फ कविता मोदी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट यूनिट 4 फ्रैक्शनल नंबर्स। इन दिस चैप्टर आवर टॉपिक्स आर टाइप्स ऑफ फ्रैक्शंस एंड फ्रैक्शंस इन लोएस्ट टर्म्स।
व्हाट इज फ्रैक्शन? फ्रैक्शन इज अ पार्ट ऑफ अ होल। When we divide a whole into equal parts, each part is a fraction of the whole. A fraction has two parts. The number on the top of the line is called the numerator. It tells how many equal parts of the whole are taken. The number below the line is called the denominator. It shows the total number of equal parts. For example, in 2 upon 7, 2 is called numerator and 7 is called denominator.
Let's see one more example. Number A is a whole circle. Number B, circle is divided into two equal parts, so each part is 1/2. Number C, circle is divided into four equal parts, so each part is 1/4. And number D, if we shed three parts of a circle, the fraction is 3/4. Our next topic is types of fractions. There are 7 types of fractions. Number 1, equivalent fractions. Number 2, proper fractions. Number 3, improper fractions. Number 4, like fractions. Number 5, unlike fractions. Number 6, unit fractions. And number 7, mixed fractions. Let me explain you one by one. Number 1, equivalent fractions. Fractions which express the same part of a whole but have different name are called equivalent fractions. For example, see the given circle. In figure A, the circle is divided into two equal parts, so each part is 1/2, so fraction of blue part is 1/2. In figure B, the circle is divided into four equal parts, so the fraction of red part is 2/4. In figure C, the circle is divided into 6 equal parts, so the fraction of green part is 3/6. In figure D, the circle is divided into 8 equal parts, so the fraction of yellow part is 4/8. So what you observe? Fraction which express the same part of a whole but have different names are called equivalent fractions. Let me explain you in another way. When we multiply the numerator and denominator of a fraction by the same number other than 0 or 1, we get an equivalent fractions. For example, find the equivalent fraction of 5/9. To find the equivalent fraction of 5/9, we multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number other than 0 or 1. If we take 4 as a common number, we get 20/36. So 20/36 is an equivalent fraction of 5/9. Let's solve one more question. Find the equivalent fraction of 3/7. Again, to find the equivalent fraction of 3/7, we multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number other than 0 or 1. If we take 5 as a common number, we get 3 5s are 15 and 7 5s are 35, 15/35. So 15/35 is an equivalent fraction of 3/7.
The next is proper fractions. Fractions whose numerators are smaller than denominators are called proper fractions. For example, 5/9, 1/2, 2/7 and 7/11. See, in each case, numerator are smaller than denominator.
The next is improper fractions. Fractions whose numerators are greater than denominators are called improper fractions. For example, 5/3, 12/5, 7/2 and 10/9. See, in each case, numerator are greater than denominator.
The next is like fractions. Fractions having same denominators are called like fractions. For example, 5 upon 9, 1 upon 9, 2 upon 9, and 7 upon 9. See, in each case, the denominators are same, means it is equal to 9.
Our next topic is unlike fractions. Fractions having different denominators are called unlike fractions. For example, 5 upon 3, 1 upon 6, 2 upon 7, and 7 upon 9. See, in these examples, all the denominators are not same. So they all are unlike fractions. The next topic is unit fractions. Fractions whose numerators are equal to 1 are called unit fractions. For example, 1 upon 7, 1 upon 9, 1 upon 3, and 1 upon 2. See, in these examples, all the numerators are 1. So it is an example of unit fractions. The next is mixed numbers. Improper fraction written as a combination of a natural number and a proper fraction is called mixed number. For example, 2, 3 upon 4. See, in this example, 2 is a natural number and 3 upon 4 is a proper fraction. And both is a combination of natural number and proper fraction. So it is an example of mixed number. The another example is 7, 1 upon 9. Next, 5, 2 upon 3, and 1, 1 upon 2. The next topic is fraction in the higher terms. Numerator and denominator are called the terms of a fraction. When we multiply the numerator and the denominator of a fraction by a common number, we get higher terms of the fraction. For example, 2 upon 5. To increase the higher term of 2 upon 5, we multiply numerator and denominator by the same number other than 0 or 1. If we take 3 as a common number, we get 6 upon 15. So 6 upon 15 is a higher term of 2 upon 5. Let's solve one more example. 1 upon 2. To increase the higher term of 1 upon 2, we multiply numerator and denominator by the same number other than 0 or 1. If we take 6 as a common number, we get 6 upon 12. So 6 upon 12 is a higher term of 1 upon 2.
The next is fraction in the lowest terms. A fraction is in its lowest terms when the numerator and denominator are prime, means no common factor other than 1. When we divide the numerator and denominator of a fraction by a common factor other than 1, we get lowest terms of the fraction. For example, reduce 18 upon 24 in the lowest term. If you see 18 and 24 both come in table of 6, or HCF of 18 and 24 is 6. If we divide 18 and 24 by 6, we get 3 upon 4, which is in the lowest term because 3 and 4 have no common factor other than 1. Or in another way, 18 upon 24 dividing by a common factor 2, we get 9 upon 12. But 9 upon 12 is not a lowest term. So again, divide 9 upon 12 by a common factor 3 and we get 3 upon 4. So 3 upon 4 is in the lowest term because 3 and 4 have no common factor other than 1. Let's solve the next question. Question number B. Reduce 12 upon 60 in its lowest term. If you see 12 and 60 both come in table of 12, or HCF of 12 and 60 is 12. If we divide 12 and 60 by 12, we get 1 upon 5. So 1 upon 5 is in the lowest term because 1 and 5 have no common factor other than 1. Or in another way, 12 upon 60 dividing by a lowest common factor 2, we get 6 upon 30, which is not in the lowest term. Remember, in order to reduce a fraction into the lowest terms, we go on dividing the numerator and denominator
by their common factors till we are left with a fraction having one as the only common factor of its numerator and denominator. 6 upon 30, both are even number, so it is divisible by 2. If we divide 6 upon 30 by a common factor 2, we get 3 upon 15. But 3 upon 15 is not in the lowest term. It is divisible by a common factor 3. So if we divide 3 upon 15 by a common factor 3, we get 1 upon 5, which is the lowest term because 1 and 5 have no common factor other than 1. See, we get same answer in both the way. So you can use any one way to reduce into lowest term. Hope you understand different types of fractions and reduce fractions in the lowest term. Students, learn and write all the definitions once in Math CW and complete lesson 4, worksheet 1, question 1 and 2 in textbook, and question number 3 in Math CW. Thank you. Have a wonderful day.